video. If you are new to our channel, please don't forget to hit that subscribe button down below. And go check out our Instagram pages where I post daily photos and updates on a lot of our animals. The links are also in the description down below. For today's video, we are gonna be doing a tortoise setup. I purchased some tortoises for a very, very good friend of mine, and I'm gonna be doing a complete setup for them and a how to care for these specific tortoises. Now, we do not have the tortoises yet. The tortoises have been purchased and they are gonna be shipped out here in the next few days. So today we are just gonna do the how to on setting up a bin for baby tortoises. We are getting two. So the tortoises that I purchased, they are babies and they are no bigger than the palm of my hand currently. That is pretty much all I know and I have to go off of to build a little baby bin for these two tortoises. Now, like I said, the tortoises are gonna be shipped out here in the next few days. I will be picking them up from a local ship center in a few days, so stay tuned for that unboxing video coming up. Somebody's being needy over here. I know, you're being needy. Now, in the future, these tortoises will need an upgraded pen or enclosure at some point, but because they are so tiny, we don't wanna do something too big and too overwhelming. So this baby bin is probably only gonna be for the next 6 to 8 months for these specific tortoises. And when we do the unboxing video in a few days, I will go over what specific tortoises we purchased and their care and all that good stuff in that video coming up in a few days. But for now, we're doing a small bin. Tortoises need some kind of hotspot for heat and just to warm up, as well as UV light. UV is very important for the absorption of calcium in order for their shells to develop properly. So we're gonna go ahead and pick up heat lamps and the UV lamps, the enclosure, substrate, hides, all of that good fun stuff here in just a moment. Okay, so I'm gonna round up my chicklets and we are gonna head out to Petco and PetSmart and probably Home Depot. So we have to go to a few different stores to get some supplies to throw together a baby bin. All right, so let's pick up the supplies we need. Yeah?
Yeah.
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 Say off to the store.
Off to the store.
Off to the store. All right, well that is it for this store. Now we are on to the next one. Two down, now we just have one left. And he is over the store. Okay, all done, now to take this show back home. Time to go home. So we just got home, and so let me show you everything that we picked up. Here is everything we picked up from the three stores that we went to. So let's start with some of the supplements we picked up. We got the Repashi brand calcium, and this is essentially like a multivitamin that we will supplement our tortoise's food 1 to 2 times a week. Now we also got another calcium with added D3. This does not have the multivitamin in it, and this will be supplemented daily on our tortoise's fresh veggies. Now we also picked up 2 different kinds of tortoise food. Both of these brands are good quality brands of food. I really like the Missouri brand, and Flukers has a very good reputation for providing quality products. So both of these are quality brand foods to supplement a small tortoise's diet. The only difference that I see is these are moist pellets. They're a little bit softer, and these are dry pellets. So we are gonna go ahead and try both of these and see what is gonna work out best for our baby tortoises. So the next things we picked up are some enrichment items for our cage, as well as I find these to be necessary, not just for enrichment, but we got a little half log for a hide so our tortoise can get in there and easily turn around. Provides a nice decorative hide. And then we also picked up some of these little, I believe these are 8-inch by 8-inch tiles that you can get from any hardware store. They are just in your home improvement aisle where all of your tiles are kept. And this is gonna be, we're gonna put these throughout the cage. And this is not only to put food on, but also to help grind down the tortoise's nails. Their nails do grow pretty quickly and they are really sharp. So this will help grind down their nails. And we picked up 3 of these to place in our cage. So the next thing we picked up is this Zoomed water bowl that is specifically designed for tortoises. So they can easily enter and exit the bowl. It's a nice ramp. Now, I went with the bigger one because there is gonna be 2 tortoises in this enclosure. And we will only be filling this up just slightly, just enough for the tortoise to be able to get in here and maybe soak and get a nice drink of water. We don't wanna fill it up too high in case the tortoise for some reason flips over. We don't want it to be able to drown. So the next things we got are the heating element. So we picked up this dome lamp, and then we are going to be doing a 100 watt heat emitter to keep the inside of this enclosure at its proper temperature and provide a little bit of a warm spot towards the warm end. And next, tortoises need UVB light in order to properly metabolize calcium for proper shell and bone growth. So we picked up this little dome lamp. And this is both the heating and this particular dome light is from Thrive. This is a PetSmart brand. And because it was Labor Day, I ended up getting these on sale, which is why I went with these. They're no different than any of your other major brands like Zoomed, Zilla, or anything else. So these work just fine. And then I got the 26 watt Desert UVB bulb to go in this fixture to provide the necessary UVB for proper absorption of calcium for our reptile. And so for the substrate for this bin, we are going to be using some organic potting soil for the bottom, and then we are going to be mixing in the Zoomed forest floor. This is 100% cypress mulch, and we're going to be mixing this in as well as providing a nice layer on top so it gives the tortoise a nice footing. So that way they don't sink when they're trying to walk across the substrate. And last but not least, the enclosure itself. We went with the 200 quart bucket. The dimensions are right there for you. And we picked this big old bucket up from Home Depot. And this should be plenty of room for our 2 tortoises for at least 6 to 8 months. And then by then they will need an upgraded custom made enclosure. So now that we have all of our supplies, we are going to go get this enclosure put together.
The next morning.
All right, guys, it is actually the next day. Yesterday kind of ran away from me, and we're gonna get this enclosure put together and finalized because our baby tortoises are gonna be on the way either today or tomorrow. I have not verified final delivery date with the shipper yet, but they should be arriving tomorrow or the next day. So we are gonna go ahead and get this enclosure finalized and put together. All right, so we have our bucket, and then I had an extra piece of this wire from when we did our rat racks. And so what I'm gonna do is I'm actually gonna cut out the top of this bucket, and I'm gonna secure this wire in there. All right, so we got our piece of grate cut. So now I've marked off the top here, and I'm gonna go ahead and cut that out. So we got this top piece cut out pretty nicely. I just used a standard razor blade, just scored the line in which I wanted to cut twice, and then it went right through, made a nice cut. So now we have our grate. Now we're gonna go get just a few washers and some nuts and bolts, and we are gonna drill some holes and secure that down. Now, there are many different ways you can do this. For my very special friend, they wanted something secure and be able to just put the fixtures on top because they have other animals and children. So they wanted to make sure that nothing could get in this bucket. If you don't have to worry about those things, you could just take the top off and do a Zoomed lampstand like this shown right here to hold the fixtures on top. Your tortoise is not going to get out of this. So something like that would work just fine and wouldn't require so much DIY work. So I have secured the top down with some washers and some different hardware that I just had lying around the garage to secure that on top. You can use whatever you want. You can use some self-tapping screws. You can use some nuts and bolts, anything that'll work. You just have to have a washer to make sure it goes over this to be able to hold it down to the plastic. I'm gonna go get this washed up now and we're gonna go ahead and put some substrate in it. The bin is washed up now, but before I ever put substrate in it, I always wipe it out with a little bit of F10 disinfectant. This is a veterinary disinfectant and it's diluted in this bottle. I can put the link in the description for this particular disinfectant, but I always wipe this out just to make sure that everything is nice and clean. A good alternative to the F10 veterinary disinfectant is your good old vinegar and water solution. So that is a good alternative if you don't want to buy the disinfectant or you can't get it for whatever reason. We have our two substrates, our organic soil and our forest floor. Now we're gonna mix the two together. That helps the tortoise's footing so they don't slip as they're walking around in the enclosure. So we have our soil in. You wanna put a generous amount. I'm gonna put some more in there as soon as I mix some of the cypress mulch. But tortoises love to dig and burrow. So you wanna make sure you give them anywhere from 3 to 6 inches. All right, so I have put the cypress mulch in. That is this lighter wood. And I have mixed it in. And that gives the tortoise a nice area to push down when they're walking so they don't just slip through the soil. Gives them a nice foundation and they're not gonna ingest these small little pieces, so no need to worry about that. So we put in, we have probably a good 4 inches of soil, and then that way if they wanna burrow, I think I'm gonna make an artificial burrow in here. So that is our substrate. So I just had some extra pieces of wood in the garage. So I just put together this little hide that I'm gonna go ahead and stick in here. So we're just gonna put that in there for a second. We're gonna take this inside and we're gonna get the whole rest of the inside of this set up. So first we're gonna get this top off. There we go. So we have this one hide that I already made in the garage. We have this half log we're gonna put in here. We have the 3 8x8 tiles. And then we have our ramp water bowl. Everything is nice and clean and ready to go in. So now we are gonna situate everything how we want it to go. Okay, we don't have the tortoises yet, so I don't know exactly how big they are. So I'm gonna set stuff in here and then things are probably gonna get moved around to accommodate them once they get here and I kind of see how they move around in the cage. But we're just gonna put stuff in a certain area just for now. It's always a work in progress. So with tortoises, you always wanna make sure that you put stuff in a manner to where they can go around it. And this water dish is huge, so I'm thinking this is probably gonna go kind of cockeyed in the middle or something. I think we're gonna half bury this thing. I think that's how I'm gonna leave it for now. Like I said, we will maneuver things around after the tortoises get here. We see exactly how big they are. I might need to take out one of these plates just so this may sit down in there a little bit better. But for now, that is the way I'm gonna leave it. So now we're gonna go ahead and put this back on and we're gonna get our lighting set up. Okay, we have all of our lighting. We have our heating elements and our UVB. And an extension cord to plug this into. For now, I am not doing a thermostat. I am gonna monitor the heat. If I need to use a thermostat, if this gets too hot for whatever reason, I do have a thermostat on hand that I can use. So the first thing you always wanna check when you're doing heating elements is you want to check the maximum wattage. This dome allows a maximum wattage of 150 watts. We are only using a 100 watt heat emitter, so we are good on the wattage for this dome fixture. So we're gonna go ahead and get the bulb put in this. Now, if you were to hang this on a lamp stand, then this is what you would put on in order to hang it. And this particular fixture is not a dimming fixture. It is a simple on and off fixture. So it's either on or it's off. Because I have the top vented so much, the heat from this should not exceed what I need it to for this particular tortoise species. So I think we're gonna be okay there. All right, and this is what the heat emitter looks like. It doesn't emit any light. It's just heat that comes out of this. All right, it is snug in there and that is ready to be plugged in. Now the same thing goes for the UV light. You always want to check the maximum wattage for your fixture. This is a 100 watt bulb or emitter. And our UV light is only 26 watts, so we are way under on that. And the same thing with this one, it comes with the hanger if you would like to do the lamp stand. And we're gonna get our bulb out. All right, and that is snugly in there. And now our two light fixtures are ready to go on top of this cage. One thing I wanna mention real quick, always keep the boxes for your lights and your dome fixtures. PetSmart and Petco typically have anywhere from a 30 to 60 day return policy. So if for some reason one of the lights starts working or something doesn't work out, you can simply return it or exchange it for a different product. So that's always good to know. I always keep the boxes for at least 60 days in the event that something malfunctions, that way I can return it or exchange it. And voila, we have lights. And the heat is already heating up. And that is our new tortoise enclosure. Now, because these are gonna be babies, I'm probably gonna end up putting some kind of paper or something on the side to block their view out a little bit to decrease the amount of stress that they might go through being new to this enclosure and to our household. But other than that, this enclosure is finished. So this tortoise enclosure is finally finished. And because it is for a very, very special friend of mine, it is currently just on a desk in our homeschool room. Yes, so that is where it's gonna stay for about 2 months until my friend returns and I can give them their new baby tortoises. So we are gonna be caring for them for the next couple months until they are ready to take them. So I hope this setup video was helpful and informational in getting your baby tortoise set up. Like I have said in the video, if you want to see specifically what kind or what species of tortoise that we have purchased, or my friend I should say has purchased, we will be unboxing the two tortoises here in the upcoming days as soon as it arrives. So again, thank you for watching. Stay safe, stay sane, and get out there and make your own footprints. I'll see you in the next one. Bye.